Do you want to animate something that you always had in mind,
but you're not sure how?
Well, now you can do it whether you know how to draw or not. Let me show you how you can animate on your mobile devices. And the app that we are going to use is called Sticknodes. Using this app, you can create simple or detailed animations of your choice. And it's not necessary that you know how to draw. To download this app, simply go to the Play Store in Android or App Store if you're using iOS, and then simply install it from there. So in today's tutorial, we will learn all the basics of Sticknodes, and we will also animate two simple animations, bouncing ball and a sword slash. Let's begin with how to use Sticknodes. So basically, this is your workspace and you create or design your frame here. You can zoom in or out, move around the character, or use all the various tools here to create your frame. So what is a frame, you may ask? The frame is just a single image in a sequence of pictures. And if we play the sequence of pictures, we will get a video. So all video consists of frames. And on top of here, we can see all the frames we have. For now, it's only showing one frame, but if I press this button, it will create a new frame and we can animate on it. For example, I will move the hand of the stickman in second frame, then I'll make another frame and move his hand again, and so on. If you made a mistake and want to delete a frame, you can press this button. If you want to play the animation, press this button. And now we can see a stickman lifting his hand. Press this button to stop the animation. Let's start how to navigate in Sticknodes. So in this side panel, we can see all the tools. On top of here, we have undo and redo. And if you scroll down, you can see all the workspace tools. Or you can access them by pressing quick menu bar. Here you can tweak the settings of your project, import stick figures, add text, and many more. If you press anywhere on your stick figure, you can access your stick figure tools in the side panel. You can change size, color, rotation, and all these different settings here. If you press on the frame, you can activate the frame tools, where you can change the color of the background and other settings that we will learn in future tutorials. If you want to access workspace tools again, just press anywhere on the workspace. If you zoom out in the workspace, you might be wondering, what is this black box? This, my friends, is a camera. This determines what will be rendered in our animation. For example, if I move this stickman here, it will be rendered in the left of the animation. Or if I move him around here, only half his body will be visible. And if we move him out of the camera, nothing will be rendered in our animation. So keep things inside camera while you animate. But what if we want to move the camera? We can do it by pressing the camera tools here. We can move the camera around the workspace, increase its size, rotation, and other settings. And with all that out of the way, we are ready to create our animations. So first delete the stickman. And now let's change the color of the background. Remember, it's inside frame tools. You can pick any color you want. I'll just pick blue. And now let's import some stick figures. I will import the floor and the ball. These are pre-installed in the library along with many other stick figures. I think it's too big, so let's scale it down. And also change its color. So we are all set. So we are gonna animate something like this. A ball bouncing across the screen and losing its momentum. So in this first frame, let's drag this ball out of the camera. And after adding a new frame, we will add the ball inside the camera. And as you can notice, we can see an onion skin of our previous frame. An onion skin is a very useful tool which helps us in directing the movement of our characters or objects. Now the ball has reached the floor, Let's bounce it back in an arc. Remember to add a new frame every time you move the ball. Let's bounce it back again, but not high as before. With every bounce, it will lose its height. And we're almost done. So let's play now to see how it looks. And yeah, it's kinda slow. So let's increase its FPS a little bit. Maybe around 20. And that's better. And say if you want to make some changes to the frames, you can easily do so by going into the frame and make changes to them as you desire. For our next animation, we're gonna download some stick figures. Go to sticknodes.com and there you can find tons of stick figures created by other users. I'm gonna download a sword from here. After you downloaded the files, go to your download folder and open the file with Sticknodes. It will open a prompt to save your files. Select your files and press save button. And now they are saved in the Sticknodes library. Let's add some stick figures to our new project. I will add a floor and a stickman and a sword that we have just downloaded. So first delete the stickman. Now let's change the background color. Add the floor and our stickman. To move the entire stickman, you drag the orange square node, and to move his limbs, you just drag the blue circle nodes. Let's get him into the stance now. That's done. Now let's add the sword. And now notice these are two different objects. But if I want to join them, I can scroll to this button and select the node where I want to join this. And now the sword is attached to his hand. Let's save this project and give it a name. And now let's continue. Let's add a new frame and create our ending pose. So this is how I want my character to end his move. So the first frame is our starting pose and the last frame is our ending pose. And in between we will add more frames and animate the movement. So here I will add a new frame in between where Stickman is running with the sword. And now if you play the animation, you can see the basic structure of our animation. Now let's add the in-between frames and make it smoother. So after the first frame, I'm gonna add a new frame. And we're gonna move the stickman a little bit to add a little bit of ease. And in the next frame, he's gonna start running up. I'm gonna add a new frame between 4th and 5th frame where the stickman swings his sword. And let's add another frame right before the last frame to add a little bit of ease. And now let's check all the frames that we have just made. And this is how it looks. For the final touch, let's add some smear effect. This sword has a built-in smear effect, so let's drag it out. For the big slash, I will import another smear. and position it like this. And finally, we are done. But don't forget to save your project.
And lastly, let's export our animation.
In free version, you can export it in GIF format. And in pro version, you can easily export it into MP4 format. Pro version also has lots of useful features and I would highly recommend it. But if you are new to Sticknodes, I would suggest you to use this app for some time and then decide.
And meanwhile, you can convert your GIF file into MP4 format using GIF to MP4 converter.
By the way, this video is not sponsored. If you're still watching the video till the end, thank you so much. I really appreciate the support from you guys. You are the best. And before going, do comment down what would you like to see next. And also, don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends. Have a nice day, guys. Peace.